This is a demonstration of checking the clutch pack clearance of a clutch pack of just about any automatic transmission or transaxle. Although this procedure is generic as far as it'll work for most transaxles and transmissions, the clutch pack that we're checking today is a direct clutch pack from a Toyota A245E automatic transaxle, like you would find in a mid-2000s Toyota Corolla. We have a dial indicator set up on the backing plate of the clutch pack. We have compressed air we're going to hit to the apply passage that's going to push on the bottom of the clutch piston and push against the return springs and compress the clutch plate. You'll notice as we do this that the dial indicator travel will change based on the amount of air pressure applied. The maximum travel allowed is 35 thousandths of an inch. I think the minimum travel is 19 thousandths on this particular clutch pack. So let's hit the air to the clutch piston. It's going to make a lot of noise, so bear with me, but watch the dial indicator. So we went up to about 28 thousandths. Notice if I just apply a little bit of pressure, it's in the low 20s. But as I hit more pressure to it, we got up to about 28 and a half thousandths of an inch. And that's clutch pack clearance, so that when the clutch pack is released, the fiber plates can spin freely of the steel plates. If the clutch pack clearance is too tight, then the clutches can rub and overheat and drag and cause abnormal transmission operation. If the clutch pack clearance is too wide, it can cause a delayed shift or even incomplete apply of the clutch plates since the piston travel is limited on the clutch pack itself.